This is something I've been wanting to do for a long time, meet and interview interesting people in the community. I'm going to visit today a very interesting person called Miriam Yerushalmi, and she is the author of a number of books which were recently released, and she's a therapist. She really helps people, and just walking up to her place now, she doesn't really like being interviewed. She's a quiet person, she's a private person. I've been pushing her to do this for a long time because she has really helped so many people, and that's my passion, helping people, healing people, and anyone that has a gift in that, we should be sharing that with the universe. I'm just pulling up here at Miriam's apartment, hope she's home, see if she's going to be willing to talk. Miriam, how are you? Good to see you. You have a few minutes to talk about your books? Your new publications? Come on, let's talk.
Yes, thank you. Welcome. Come in.
Thank you. Oh, it's so nice here.
Yeah, I'd like to introduce you to Yaffa Gottlieb.
Hi, Yaffa.
Hi.
I've heard of Yaffa Gottlieb.
I've heard of Chaim Miller as well.
You're an author, right?
Correct.
Very nice to meet you. So let's sit down and...
Yeah, she's been like my dear friend for so many years and helped me so much along the way.
Well, awesome. It's a very worthwhile cause because I benefited greatly from your books.
Awesome. There's the books. Oh, my God. Shining. Okay, let's sit down for a minute and hear all about... So you told me before that you started writing children's books because of one of your kids.
Yes, you won't believe this story, but I used to give chinuch ideas through different fun stories, especially with characters that my son loved. He loved fish, he loved falafel. So I would just take things that he loved and then just kind of make up stories to get the idea across. So one day he asked me to make it into a real book. And I'm like, oh, okay. So I took some scrap paper, taped it up together and presented to him. And he said, no, a real book. So then the idea...
So let's take a look at the two adult books that you've just published.
Reaching New Heights Through Prayer and Meditation.
Wow, what a great title.
I love the title, actually.
So this teaches you how to use prayer to change?
Yes. I mean, right. It really is the main secret ingredients from deep Kabbalistic teachings, from Tanya, from Sichas of the Rebbe, of how to transform yourself.
Now let's talk to Yaffa a minute. I understand you've read the book? You've read the prayer book?
One thing about Miriam's books is that every page has something on it that you can gain from. I was just experimenting right now. I'm open up to one page and let's see if I can just one page, what is it going to tell me? And it was very, very useful and relevant.
And you also published another adult book. Do you want to just show us that one?
Yeah, so this is Reaching New Heights Through Kindness in Marriage.
Yeah. So I was so thrilled to see this coming out because, let's face it, marriage is not in a good situation in our culture.
Oh,
and
right.
And even in our own Orthodox community, so many young people getting divorced. Oh, it's like a plague.
It really is.
And there's really not that many materials from a Jewish perspective, especially from a Hasidic perspective. From the Rebbe's talks, there's not a lot of accessible stuff, and it's really accessible. You want to tell us about the marriage book?
Well, one thing I'd like to say first is what's different about this book and unique. Baruch Hashem, there are some out there, but this makes it sink in better. This book has the visualizations, the meditations, the question and answers. It's like also a workbook.
Yeah.
So that a person could actualize the knowledge that it is, imparted.
It has like the practicality of a book you'll buy in Barnes & Noble, like a secular self-help book. The end of every chapter, here's the exercise, here's what to do, here's what to think. Did you do it? Check-off list, which most from books don't have that, most awful. Well, it's a really nice day today. Why don't we just go out for a walk and carry on talking outside?
Absolutely.
Weather's so nice. Want to come for a walk?
Yeah.
Let's go. We don't want to get run over on camera. That would not be a good idea. Go, let's go.
I think a common thread that goes through them is that children get a lot of self-confidence in being who they are and in guidance in becoming what they want to be.
Mm.
Rare in children's books in the form that children can relate to and enjoy.
Wow.
That is perfect. I love what you just said. I couldn't have said it better. You know, and people go to bar mitzvahs, right, from a very young age, and the children don't even know what's really going on. So I wanted children from a very young age to know what is bar mitzvah all about.
Yeah.
Why do we put it on the head? Why do we put it on the arm first? What's the symbolism? How is it connected to our day-to-day avodas Hashem?
Hmm.
And in this book is all these messages.
So let's see it.
Yay.
Let's get them out.
And even though this is the Yiddish one. The other one I gave to the...
Just pull out a book.
Oh, mm-hmm.
Yeah. This is what it's like to be an author. You have tons of books stuffed in your car.
They were
a permanent
in there nicely.
Fixture. Yeah.
Okay. Here, oh, there's a Yiddish one.
So this is a Yiddish version of an English book that you published previously.
Okay.
This is another Yiddish one about going to Eretz Yisrael.
Right, some of them this are, is the Eretz Yisrael Yiddish one.
Let's just flick through it because there's lovely pictures in there.
Oh my gosh, amazing.
This work.
Yeah. Oh, look at the back.
Yeah.
Oh.
Very nice.
I was buying
pictures
and I'm like, can you do this artwork? And could you? And then Baruch Hashem. Let's see. Yama Melach.
Nice. Beautiful.
This is the Ma'arat HaMakpelah.
This is chapter 4 of Tanya.
Wow.
After I read chapter
That's
4
amazing.
Of Tanya, I was thinking, like, because it talks about the garments of the soul.
Mm.
Garments, they make them more beautiful, right?
And okay, let's go to the park.
Yay, it's such a beautiful day. I was like praying, please.
Glad we didn't do this last week. Our noses would have fallen off.
So
tell
cool.
me, can you talk and drive at the same time? Well, they say women can do two things at once.
Actually, I do a lot of therapy over the phone.
Are you serious?
While driving, actually. Don't tell. I don't want to get...
So what happens to Fievel the Falafel when he tries to do a mitzvah?
So he's left in the restaurant and he's antsy. Like, he needs to do something with his life. Like, he's not meant to just... sit there. His sparks want to be elevated.
Right.
And he wants to also do mitzvahs.
Mm.
But then he realizes that he wants to do miftoim too. Like getting other people to do mitzvahs with him. So he gets the tachina and the and chani chumos and sarla the salad and pinchas the pickle.
Mm.
And he gets them to join on the skateboard in this journey to find a poor person
What's
and feed them.
Now?
Oh, right there, he's like annoyed because
he wants
more latkes.
Uh-huh.
And
so
the Yetzirah tries to like trick him into, you know, really being mad about it. And then here we're introducing the Yetzer Tov to the child so that they would understand that there's this dual, like, rivalry in the child's mind of what to do and what not
so
to do.
Basically, in the morning, we're building... the day.
Mm.
And so even just one meditation.
So when am I doing this?
This is
when
at any point in one of the tefillah meditations that I talk about in the book. For instance.
Oh, okay. So pick one part of the prayers? Because you can't meditate the whole prayer. It's too long, right?
Well, you know, I kind of like to explain it in a way like when you have to eat your daily meals, right?
Mm-hmm.
So like you spice it up. You have the same thing every day.
Right.
And you practically do, right? You have the salad every day and you have
So like, where am I going to put my special dish?
Right.
Take
so
a piece of the prayers.
Yeah, spice it up by this day oregano, you know, this day basil. So, I know, lahavdil.
Yeah.
But, so, that's why this book was made, so people can take one meditation one day and another meditation another day and spice it up.
So this is like a recipe book. For your prayers.
Yeah. And it's
like,
literally...
You don't want to eat the same thing every day. You'd get bored. You don't want to pray the same thing every day. So here's a dish for the day.
Right.
Someone wants to improve their marriage.
Right.
In 1 minute.
One
what would you
thing,
tell them?
I mean, how many years and years and years of me being a counselor and I just helped them realize that you got to be empowered to rise above the nitty-gritty negativity of your spouse. And just like you have to rise above with the nitty-gritty negativity of your children. There's no difference. And people say, well, he's an adult or she's an adult. And I'm like, but it's all the same game. Some people lash back out and they put gasoline on a burning fire.
Mm.
But if they would just step back and allow the rain to put it out by their raining on them kindness. So that empowers the person not to take personally, because they, at a gut level, very visceral level, realize, wait a minute, I can't change so perfectly in a blink of an eye. So why am I demanding and expecting and taking personally their negativity and their challenges of being the perfect tzaddik like we wish them to be?
Right. So we just need to appreciate that when people are acting, even our spouse, they're doing it because they have a struggle. They're just, that's coming from their personal history.
Yes.
We should be more gentle with them. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah. I mean, some people are born with a fiery temperament, like a baker's oven, and some people are born frigid.
You have written the marriage book twice. Once in a Jewish version, and then you've adapted it also for a non-Jewish audience or a general audience.
Yes. Which was a must. Because, first of all, a lot of even... like Jewish people are not so connected to the Hasidic philosophy that they might be like, nah, not for me.
Yeah.
And a lot of Hasidic families might have children who are a bit off the derech or not so Hasidic, but they're, you know, they're challenged in their marriages or about to get divorced, and they want to like give them something.
Yeah.
And also for the goyim, I mean, they're suffering too.
Right. Well, I've had a good walk. Have you got some exercise? And congratulations on
thank
all your books.
You, really.
I really bless you that you should lift up many souls, heal many spirits, and bring positivity to the world. And check out Miriam's books. It really, she has a lot to offer. And I'm going to go. But have a great day.
Thank you.